Hello and welcome to the history of Babylon 5. Today's episode, Nightwatch. And here we go. The Nightwatch Division was a paramilitary organization under the Ministry of Peace, which was set up during the presidency of Morgan Clark in 2259. Nightwatch was established to recruit ordinary citizens, including local law enforcement, and encourage them to uncover and report on what were perceived to be subversive activities. Each subversion was deemed to include open criticism of Earth Alliance policy or the Clark regime, interacting with aliens or anything more than a professional basis, or anything else Clark deemed to be a threat to his new order. The Nightwatch had the power and authority to make arrests without warrants, detain suspected subversives indefinitely, and spy at will on the population. Nightwatch began offering credits to various people to be their eyes and ears. Babylon 5 security officer Zach Allen and others decided to join, initially in it for the extra money. Allen soon became more and more disturbed over the escalation of Nightwatch's activities and the erosion of civil liberties that were happening with Nightwatch around. Nightwatch and the Ministry of Peace were very closely integrated and were, for all practical purposes, one and the same. By the time the Ministry attempted to assign Julie Masanti to Babylon 5 as a political officer, Masanti attempted to compromise Sheridan by bedroom politics, which failed. Later addressing the station's Nightwatch contingent, she informed them that they were now part of the political office, telling Zach his concern over due process was moot when he raised the question. With the events of Earth coming to a head, Captain Sheridan and the others knew that Nightwatch was a threat they would have to deal with. When Clark issued a decree imposing martial law, Nightwatch was ordered to take over station security. Finding a loophole in the order, Sheridan stated that since he had been issued orders by a civilian office outside the military chain of commands, the orders were therefore illegal, knowing he finally had a way of dealing with the Nightwatch. Sheridan approached Zach, who agreed to help the command staff take care of the threat. Going to his Nightwatch superiors, he revealed that a ship was arriving with a number of Narns who would take over station security. Believing that they would catch Sheridan in the act, nearly all Nightwatch personnel went to the airlock where the ship was supposed to be docking. When everyone was assembled in the docking area, Zach gave the orders that sealed the Nightwatch personnel in the room, placing them all under arrest. Sheridan charged all of them for attempting mutiny and failure to respect the chain of command. Each Nightwatch operative was ordered to come out one at a time and surrender their weapons, equipment, and links. Sheridan then revealed that the local Narn population was then going to join the remaining human Babylon 5 security, as he put it, hiding a lie within the truth. The official Nightwatch presence on Babylon 5 ended after the station declared independence from the Earth Alliance. All the known Nightwatch personnel were sent back to Earth, but a small covert group eluded capture, briefly taking Ambassador Delenn and several other Minbaris as hostage. They were finally either killed or captured when the station's command staff initiated a rescue. Though the Babylon 5 branch of the organization was shut down, the Nightwatch remained an active force throughout the Earth Alliance until Earth itself was liberated by the Resistance. Hey, thank you for watching the history of Babylon 5. Special thanks to the Babylon Project for all information you heard today. Very special thanks to my Patreons and to Royalty Free Tube for this fantastic background. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you can. If you have, thank you. And have a great day. Bye-bye.